What's going on, guys? Welcome back to another video. In this video, we're going to be talking about Palantir Technologies and how there are two extremely important catalysts that we need to look out for coming into these next couple of weeks. These are very important events and could be a very big deal and could have a significant impact on the share price of Palantir. The first one that we're going to go over is the RPP prototyping competition, in which Palantir is one of the 11 finalists and could be receiving a very substantial contract from the FDIC. Then we're going to briefly cover some of the updates that we have received out of the DoubleClick Demo Day event. That event is coming up next week, so that is definitely something that you guys should watch if you have a substantial position in Palantir. So before we get into all of that information, if you guys would like to earn two free stocks with Webull valued up to $1,850, Webull is the brokerage that you guys see on screen in all of my videos. All you have to do is sign up for an account, deposit over $100, and you get those two free stocks. This is also a great way for you guys to help out and support the channel, because when you guys complete those sign up and deposit tasks, I also get a free stock as well. And if you guys enjoy the information and analysis that I provide for you in these videos, make sure you go down and hit that like button. And if you want to see more videos like this, make sure you hit that subscribe button and turn on that notification bell so you're notified every time I post a new video, so you get to stay up to date on all of your favorite stocks, learn about a couple of new ones, and see exactly which options I am trading and which strategies I am using to trade them. And I apologize for not putting out the amount of videos that I have been doing in the past. This last week has been pretty overwhelming for me. I've had so many different exams. All of my professors, I am in college, by the way, if you guys did not know, all of my professors decided to give me all of my exams within a really short time frame. So I've been kind of swamped with work, but I thought I would be able to get this video out to you guys. And as you guys are watching this, I am finally done with all of my tests. So we're going to be able to get back to the typical posting schedule. And I also want to address some of your guys' concerns about what is going on with Palantir and some of the other hyper growth stocks that we have been talking about on this channel. So this past year, I think we've seen a lot of opportunity for kind of get-rich-quick stocks in terms of options plays or stocks that just massively run up over a 1 to 2 month time frame. Now, those opportunities aren't being seen as much in the market. We have seen some significant pullbacks, and these hyper-growth stocks are chilling out. We've seen significant sell-offs, and we really haven't seen them bounce off the lows. Now, I want you guys to ask yourselves a question. Do you think the fundamentals of the businesses that you have put your money into have significantly changed over the past month? If the answer is yes, then you might want to reevaluate your position and investment into the company. If that answer is no, then I think that these sell-offs and dips are just amazing buying opportunities for the long term. Now, for Palantir, in my opinion, now nothing I say in these videos is financial advice. These are for educational and entertainment purposes only, but my investment horizon for Palantir is going to be over 10 years. So these short-term dips to me are not a big deal. I have a lot of confidence in Palantir's business model as a company over the long term, and these small dips just provide a great buying opportunity for me to buy more. I've also seen a lot of posts around the internet, especially on the Reddit forums, where Palantir puts out great news and everybody's expecting it to go down 5%. Now, that does seem like what has been happening over the past couple of weeks, but you have to take this news at face value. They're coming out with new contracts, great news. This is just solidifying Palantir as a great investment, in my opinion. In these short-term price movements and the volatility that we are seeing right now, in my opinion, doesn't matter all that much over the long term. So let's take a look at the option chain to go over this unusual options activity again. And I want to make it very clear to you guys why at this specific time that I am looking at this unusual options activity. So the reason is that the last time Palantir had its demo day was right here. So we saw Palantir on January 26th right here have its demo day event. In the after hours period, Palantir dropped and then significantly rallied up to all-time highs over the next couple of days. Now, the market conditions were different then. We did see some the rallies break out with GameStop and AMC and a couple of other of these quote-unquote meme stocks. So that did give us an extra boost, but we did see a significant run-up before. Now, around here at this $25, $24 mark, we were looking at the unusual options activity in Palantir, and we decided to get into the $30 strike for an expiration date that was after the demo day event. Now, if you guys know my options trading strategy, I never put an amount into a trade that I'm not fully willing to lose, so I typically trade with $250 to $1,000. And if you want to see how I trade options, make sure you guys go check out that options trading playlist that I have for you guys. There's some really important strategies there. I typically trade events and earnings because those provide the most significant run-ups in share price. So now let's actually get into the actual unusual options activity. So I'm set to puts right now, so we're gonna have to change that. So when we come over to April 16th, this is going to cover by a couple of days the double-click demo day event. When we come over to the calls, we can see the 25s have an extremely high open interest. We can see that the 30s have an extremely high open interest. Now, that is typical that the multiples of five have a higher open interest than maybe these 29 and a halves and a couple of these other ones, but we can see that the volume on the calls is extremely high. So the volume is essentially the amount of options that were bought and sold, the options contracts that were bought and sold in a given day. And I think we could see this open interest on these 25 significantly jump up over the next couple of days with this amount of volume. Now, what you also have to look at is the put side. What is the open interest in the volume on the puts? We can see that there's not a lot of action compared to the calls, and the volume is a lot lower. So this does tell me that options traders are very bullish on Palantir going into the next couple of weeks. But we have in the past, you got to keep in mind that we've seen that these open interest on these 30s, these 25s and the 35s have been very high, and they've expired worthless over the last couple of weeks. But what's different about this specific expiration date is that we do have significant events coming up. So then when we come over to this right here, this is going to be the rapid phased prototyping. So this is an important part of FDI Tech. The rapid phase prototyping competition is designed to accelerate the adoption of modern technological tools to help financial institutions, particularly community banks, provide more timely and granular data to the FDIC in a more effective and efficient manner. In addition, these new tools will help the FDIC gain greater insight into the financial health of these institutions and allow for more efficient supervision. So the status as of January 2021, 11 companies were selected to participate in the phase three portion in December 2020. A brief overview of each company's solution can be found below. So Palantir is one of these 11 companies. Now, when we come down a little bit further, we can see that this is going to be the prototyping process. They started out with a concept paper. They then went to an initial prototype, which was about in January of 2021, maybe even December. The actual dates are listed below. The final prototype was presented in mid-March, and the production contract is going to be given after. So we are right here. We are after the final prototype and in the production contract space. Now, it is possible that Palantir does not receive this contract, but this would be huge for Palantir if they were able to receive this. We can see phase one concept papers, August 13th, 2020. Phase two initial prototypes, mid-December 2020. The FDIC hosted demo days to allow vendors to present their initial prototypes. And then the phase three, which Palantir was invited into. We can see the mid-March, which we have passed. FDIC host demo days to allow vendors to present their final prototypes. This final phase of the process allows awardees to continue prototyping their concepts, which may include developing higher levels of functionality, engaging in user testing, and discussing other technical details. In phase four, the production contract, that is where we are at right now. Now, when we come down a little bit further, here are some of the companies that Palantir is competing against. We have Actis, Bearing Point, DS Quorum, Fed Reporter, Fidelity Information Services, First Data Government Solutions, Neocova Corporation, Novantas, Palantir, PeerIQ, and S&P Global Marketing Intelligence. Now, I don't know a lot about these other companies, but I do know that Palantir would be a very good fit for this deal. Now, when we come over here, Palantir has also been mentioned in this TD Bank job posting, which I was able to find through a Reddit posting. So thank you to this user over here who was able to find this information. Now, when we come over here, we can see that Palantir was directly mentioned. Now, I do want to say a couple of things about this. We've seen Palantir mentioned in Facebook job postings, Apple job postings, and a couple of other of these as well. And now I do think that it is possible that in the future, Palantir will be able to gain some contracts from these these tech giants. I don't think that's what that means at the current time. I think that what is happening here is that the hiring people, the actual people who want to recruit people into their company at TD Bank, Facebook, need people that have the technical capabilities to operate or create platforms similar to Palantir. So we see a lot of these different platforms listed here. And I think that is what's occurring. Rather than TD Bank telling us in a cryptic way in this job posting that they are looking at engaging in a contract with Palantir. Now we have the demo day. So when we come over here, we can see that the Palantir provided a couple of new updates on this demo day, which are going to be very interesting to see. But the key thing that I'm really interested in learning more about out of this demo day, if they are able to share this information, is that if you guys remember when Palantir released its ERP suite through the Amazon Web Services platform, they were able to save British Petroleum $50 million of working capital in just 2 weeks. If Palantir is able to show us directly how they were able to do this for BP, and a lot of these other companies out in the market right now see that Palantir's software can save them this much money in a short amount of time, this is going to create so much more business for Palantir. Because just think about it, if Palantir's software is able to save them money and they are able to free up some capital, become more efficient as a company, and use that capital to grow or do whatever they want, they are obviously going to go with Palantir over these other software providers. So that is the thing that I am most interested in learning more about at this DoubleClick demo day. Now, it is hinted here. So it says that the first installment of Palantir's DoubleClick series. So that means to me that we're going to see multiple of these throughout 2021. So if we see a lot of positive price movement after this event, I think that could suggest to us that when Palantir does have a DoubleClick demo day event coming up, we could see a significant run up into the share price. Now, the reason for that is a lot of investors and big money is going to flow into Palantir if they are expecting good news. It is very similar to an earnings run up in that a lot of people are speculating what is going to happen after an event occurs. If previously they had great news at one of these events, people are going to be more likely to think that Palantir is going to have an increase in share price after this event because of the good news that they are going to put out. So that is going to conclude this update on Palantir. If you guys enjoyed the information and analysis that I provided for you in this video, make sure you go down and hit that like button. And if you want to see more videos like this, make sure you hit that subscribe button and turn on that notification bell so you're notified every time I post a new video, so you get to stay up to date on all of your favorite stocks, learn about a couple of new ones, and see exactly which options I am trading and which strategies I am using to trade them. So I hope you guys are having a really profitable day, and I'll see you guys in the next video.